When I was a teenager, I was obsessed with American muscle boats, and the one I really, really liked was the formula range of SRI boats, which ran from about 25 up to 40 feet. So you can imagine how excited I was when a friend of mine called me up recently and said, I bought a formula SRI, and not any, this is the big one. This is the 419. Look at that. This is the stuff of teenage dreams, and it still looks absolutely fantastic today. So we're gonna have a little look around this one, and with a bit of luck, tomorrow, we're gonna take this for a run out. So stay tuned. This is a video that's gonna be worth seeing. But as I say, we're gonna start off with a look around the boat first of all, give you a bit of a yacht tour, and show you what this beast is all about. So it is classic American muscle boat style. You've got the big sun pad on the back over the engines, and then you've got the bucket seats here, and then the drop bolster seats up at the front. So let's have a hop on, and I'll show you around. Okay, so back here, as I say, you have these wonderful bucket seats ahead of the engine, and look at these chunky fellas here. What I love is that this is all original. So it's the proper original formula color scheme. It's exactly how I remember them. And then you've got the engine instruments and controls just here. This is what I mean about these drop bolster seats. So you can drop the base down, or you can have it flat to sit on. But the idea is that when you're running really fast, you've got a really good position to wedge yourself in. And that's the view down the foredeck. Stunning. We'll kind of come back to this area in a moment and I'll explain a little bit more, but let's have a look inside first of all. So this is what is inside an American muscle boat. And again, it's absolutely classic. It's what you'd expect to find. And it's the layout that you see time and again on this sort of boat. So there's a, well, as you can see, big seating area. And then ahead of that is a double bed up in the bow. And in fact, you can convert this area where I'm sat so that this can be a double bed as well, so you can sleep four if you want to. And then back on this side, there's a little bar area and television, and then the galley is opposite with a sink and a small cooker underneath. And then there's a fridge inside this one. And finally, on this side, there's a great little heads compartment. So it's everything you need for a long weekend or even a week away. But let's go and talk about the oily bits, because they are particularly interesting on this boat. So if we take a look at this dash area again, one thing you'll notice is there are triple levers and triple levers, triple rev counters, and by now you've probably realised that this is a triple engine boat. If we pull this little lever here, that'll lift the back, and I'll show you what this boat is all about. Now, when this boat was originally made, it was in 1991, and it would have had Mercruiser in, big V8 Mercruisers. But in around 2006, it was re-engined, and it now sports these nanny diesels, which make the whole operation a lot more economical, but still got high performance. These are 320 horsepower each, so you've got nigh on 1,000 horsepower going out there, and that's giving the boat top speed close to 50 miles an hour. So it's a properly quick boat, as you'd expect. And these are linked to three Bravo drives, and that's what gets that power down into the water. Now, what's interesting about this boat is that these engines were fitted around about 2006, we believe, but then the boat disappeared into a barn for about 7 years, then changed hands, and the chap who bought it went right through, did all the engineering, got everything right up to spec, got it all working properly, and now it's changed hands again. My friend has bought it, and he's now going to go through and do all of this upholstery, keep it all original, but get it really up to standard. So that's the story, but as I say, it doesn't end here. With a bit of luck tomorrow, we're going to head to sea on this fine ship, and we're going to live the dream. I'm finally going to find out what it's like to drive a Formula SRI powerboat, and the biggest one that they make. Can't wait. Okay, this is it. This is a teenage dream come true. This is meeting Farrah Fawcett from the Cannonball Run. Here we go. So three levers, all into gear, and it's all on these throttles, and we're going to wind on close to 1,000 horsepower. See how it goes. Let's go. Okay, turbos are spinning up, bows up, bows down, and we're off. Okay, that has got some grunt. So we're cruising now, she's at about 3,000 RPM, and
that's giving us about 35, 36 miles an hour. So that's about 32, 33 knots, and that's what this boat cruises at. And I'm not going to push it hard because it's not my boat. I'm going to stick with that, but all I'm interested to see is how it handles. Because the hulls on these are incredible. So, we're clear of everybody. Here we go, race yourself, Sheila. Okay, yeah, so that is pretty spectacular. That is the real deal. Unbelievable. And it's cutting through the water like the proverbial knife through butter. What a machine. So it turns out my teenage crush was right. I wanted one of these when I was 18, and I want one now. It's brilliant.